Today, I'm taking a look at a shoe that I wasn't quite sure I'd be able to make it to 100 miles in. That's the Saucony Ride 13. Miles and 9 minutes 11 seconds from 139 beats per minute today, going out there for a nice and easy long run, also picking up a dog along the way. That dog ran with me for about 7.5 miles before it left me and decided to go back home. And with today's miles, I was able to get the Saucony Ride 13 to the 100 mile mark. Now, before I give you my thoughts on this shoe after 100 miles, I do want to go over some disclosures. This is a pair of shoes that was sent to me for the purpose of a review by Roadrunner Sports. However, they're not paying me to make this video or to use this shoe, and they're not going to get a chance to preview any of my footage or my thoughts before you guys get a chance to see this video on YouTube. So what do we have in the Saucony Ride 13? I would say that this is a cushioned daily trainer with 32 millimeters of stack height in the heel, coming down to 24 millimeters of stack height in the forefoot, giving an 8 millimeter drop. Full of PWRRUN midsole foam. And altogether, this tire package comes in at 9.7 ounces. I absolutely love this shoe at first. I think I started running in the shoe around June this year. I remember it was in the summer months because it was a little bit hot. And I really appreciated a lot of the changes that were in the shoe. A lot of the changes that I love come down to the PWRRUN, that new midsole foam that's in the shoe. But also it shed a lot of weight from previous years. And also it just became a little bit more flexible of a shoe. When my foot hits the ground, it can kind of do more of what it naturally wants to do. We've also lost a lot more of the foam that was in this area that made the shoe really hot. I just felt like it was unnecessary foam. Now, don't get me wrong, there's still a bunch of padding in this tongue and a lot of foam that's very comfortable on your recovery days or your long run days that's around the heel cup, but they've kind of toned it down to a level that I think is really nice for what this shoe is, which is that cushioned daily trainer. But I then started to have some issues with this shoe. And to be fair to Saucony and this shoe, it wasn't all this shoe's fault. But what I think was the problem was Saucony likes to put a hint of stability on like the inner part on a lot of their shoes. I think here you can see there's that red piece of rubber that kind of highlights that area where it is, where I think the foam is a little bit more dense. So it's kind of like a stability shoe in a neutral shoe package. A lot of people love that feature and flock to Saucony because of it. But for me, I didn't really love it so much. And I found that when I ran in a lot of Saucony shoes for a lot of days in a row, it started to bother my knee. And at that time, I was running a lot of mileage, more mileage than I'd ever run before. And also running in these shoes with that hint of stability that was already baked in. And I think that all contributed to some exacerbating some muscle imbalance issues that I'd had with my foot strike and my gait. And I developed runner's knee. Again, not completely because of the shoe, but one of the pieces, I think, of that puzzle. That all was about like 3 months ago. It's been a process to kind of get back. And in that time, I had to put down the Ride 13, take a break from the Saucony shoes that I was running in. I was running in the Ride 13, the Triumph 18. I reduced my mileage, started doing some mobility work, single leg strength exercises to work on some of those muscle imbalances, kind of get myself correct before I could get back into these Sauconys. And I've been trying it here and there very cautiously, and I saw progress. I felt like, yep, it wasn't necessarily the shoe. I'm getting stronger. I'm fixing the things that I needed to take care of. To the point where now I feel like I'm like 99% recovered from this runner's knee issue, and I feel like I can get back in these Saucony Ride 13s again, and I'm very excited about that because I've missed the shoe. I really loved running in the shoe, and I'm very glad to have been able to get back in it. This past week, I did 2 11-mile runs with it within the same week, which I felt like was a really good test of my knee, but it was also a good reminder of what this Ride 13 is all about. It was great for those 11-mile runs. And now that it's winter time, one of the biggest knocks that I had on the shoe was that like the all that padding in the upper made the shoe really hot for the summertime. Now that it's almost December, I'm really appreciating the extra warmth that all that foam and padding provide. So it's actually turning into a positive for the shoe. Now, the engineered mesh still feels really great. The toe box feels nice and roomy. I went true to size and it still feels fantastic even after the 100 miles. The PWRRUN still feels great in this shoe as well. Definitely feels like I picked up right where I left off in a good way with this shoe, and that PWRRUN foam, even after 100 miles, still feels like it's got plenty of life left. There is a little bit of wear, which I'm a little bit surprised about, on the outsole that I think is a little bit more than I would expect for 100 miles. Now I'm seeing the wear in the two normal spots that I see wear on my running shoes. One is right here underneath the ball of the foot, and the other is kind of on the outer part of the heel. It's not something that it's like, oof, the shoe's falling apart, but it's probably a little bit more wear than I would expect to see of a shoe at this point at 100 miles. The other thing that I'm noticing with this shoe on the right-hand side is that the side that's opposite of that hint of stability seems to be extra worn out, especially on the right side, which is the leg where my knee was hurting. And I feel like the foam might have even compressed a little bit more on this side than it might normally compress in a shoe for me. So I think that hint of stability is definitely kind of making me hit further on the outside of the shoe, which again, I think for a lot of people is probably a good thing, but for me, I think was exacerbating stuff that wasn't really working out for me. So all that stuff is kind of still happening, but I think now because my leg is stronger, I've kind of corrected a lot of the major muscle imbalances that I have, I think I'm able to kind of deal with it for now. Although I'm still gonna be a little bit cautious about introducing the Saucony shoes back into the lineup. I'm not gonna go out there every day and bang out 10 miles a day every day, but I feel like I'm good enough to a point where I can enjoy these shoes that I have really been liking. Because all the like the things aside about in terms of the shoe not like agreeing with me, the shoe itself, if you're someone that likes that hint of stability, I think you're really gonna love what they did with the Ride 13 this year. The PWRRUN's been holding up really well. The upper is absolutely fantastic. It looks pristine, still feels really great. The outsole has a little bit more wear on it that I would normally expect at this point, but I also feel like the Ride series has been known for being like an extra durable shoe in the Saucony lineup, so I don't have any doubts about like the ultimate long-term longevity of this shoe. It's not exactly the fastest shoe. It can certainly be pushed to a little bit of a faster pace, but it doesn't really love being there. What it loves doing is going out there for your long, easy runs, for your recovery runs, stuff where you want to be a little bit more relaxed, a little bit more enjoyment, and more ease in your run. That's exactly when I would reach for this shoe. Or if you're a person that doesn't love like all the extra-ness that can happen in max cushion shoes, but want something that's going to be great for those long runs and those easy runs, I think the Ride 13 is definitely something that you should put into your consideration. So those are my thoughts on the Ride 13 after 100 miles. I'm very happy that I was able to get this shoe to the 100 mile mark because I have been enjoying it so much in the overall scheme of things. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions about this shoe, or better yet, I do a live stream every day on YouTube, 3 p.m. Central Time. You can always feel free to ask me a question there. That's all I have for today, everybody. Thanks so much for making it all the way to the end of the video. Hopefully you guys are staying safe out there on your runs, and I'll see you in the next one.
Yo, what's going on?